think about us wise guys. The hustle never ends. You shot me at that motel, your life would have been flushed on a piece of dude.
Please, Tony, I'm begging.
About us wise guys, the hustle never ends. About us wise guys. About us wise guys. About us wise guys. About us wise guys.
About us wise guys, the hustle never ends.
About us wise guys. About us wise guys. About us wise guys. About us wise guys.
Good morning, welcome to the first episode in the Vlog special series. As always, joined by Mr. Rees.
What's up?
Pleasure to have you on, Sunshine. We was meant to be down Medway Valley doing a casting for cancer event, but unforeseen circumstances, a bit of misunderstanding, mate. We wanted to get fishing. Turned up yesterday down at Medway and found out that we weren't allowed to fish till 8 this morning, so we blew it out and we've actually come to your stomping ground, son, down the old end of Silver.
Yeah.
So as I say, we got here late last night, 8 o'clock, set up in the dark, just pub chucks. I stuck a couple of solid bags out, I've had a couple of tench. But me old mucker Harry here.
Done it, don't I?
Done
bad
the
time.
Business. Because, you know, like, I'll catch.
Yeah, but it sort of went, you catch. Now, I'll catch.
No, you've caught.
Finally.
So, he's got a nice one in the sling. Nice common, about 4 o'clock this morning. He woke me up. And as I say, yeah, we ain't weighed it or nothing. We just slinged it up, put it out there in the water, let it rest, and waited for the light. So, we're going to finish up the tees, get the fish out, do the business, hold it out for some shots. And then I think it's time to go to work, mate, because as I say, it was pub chucks last night, wasn't it?
It is, mate, trying to find a few good spots and just get the bait out there, concentrate a bit.
Yeah, mate, yeah. All right, well, like I say, finish the tea and we'll hold the old fish up for you. Well, there you go. 24-4, not bad for a pub chuck, son.
That's it, turned up late last night, waked a few baits out, a few baits around it, smashed it.
18 mil nutcracker?
Loving it, mate, all day long.
It's the one, isn't it?
Yeah.
We'll get the snaps done then, son, get this one back, and we'll go to work.
Yeah, wicked, love it.
What a roll stunner, that one, isn't she?
Good one, isn't it?
What a roll stunner. Happy days.
Love it.
Right, so we've had the marker out. 12 and a half wraps. I found there's a 14-foot drop straight into a silty little gut. It's a hole, basically, about 3 foot either side. So it drops right down to 14 foot. Pull it back, and it comes up to 12, and it's really vicious gravel. So we're gonna pop the marker up there, and we're gonna fish to that with clips up. So we're gonna make the mix now that we're gonna put out in the spod, literally. Got 18 mil nutcracker. I'm gonna put probably half a key to a kilo out on the spot. Fish one rod on that, and then we'll work on another spot and try and find another one. In the mix, basically, it's just gonna be whole 18 mil boilies. I'm gonna chop some in half. I'm gonna put a lid full of Foss oil in, just to glaze the boilies. Some Almond Supreme smoke and a normal bit of Almond Power smoke goo. Mix that up, nice fluffy mix. And then no crumb, because last night in the PVA bags we was getting picked off by the tench with the crumb. So we're going to go boily approach, but we're going to go halves, because obviously the more bait that's there, the more chance we've got of drawing something in. So we're going to mix this up now, and we'll get some bait on the spot.
Thank you.
Right, so I've just found my second spot for my right hand rod. There's a bar that runs through the middle of the lake. We found 5 foot on top, and I've dropped down to 8 foot into the start of the silt, between the bar and the shelf, if you like. I'm right at the bottom of the bar. Again, same mix went out. About half a key, kilo of nutcracker, some whole bait, some halves, a bit of foss oil, and the old almond supreme and the almond goo. So we've got two spots baited, so I'm just going to tie up some new rigs now. The rods are all clipped and ready to go. So it's just a case of getting the rigs ready, getting the bait out. We sit on it for about an hour, let that settle before we put the rods out. So we've got plenty of time, we're here till Sunday. So yeah, like I say, tie the rigs, have a cup of tea, go and see Harry and see if we can get him on some spots as well. And then, yeah, we'll crack on. Hopefully the session carries on how it started off. Few less tents though, mind you, and don't really fancy having the bream that I'm seeing top in front of me, but one of them old scalies would be nice right now. Right, just to run you through the rigs for the session. Start off with the left hand rod, the one that's in the deep water, onto the gravel spot at about 12 foot. It's literally an 18mm nutcracker boilie, and we've tipped it with a bit of Evolution Tackle's Kong. Now what it is, that's a corn stack. I've just cut one of the grains out of the free corn stack. They're great toppers, they're a really nice bit of kit, really soft. They actually take on flavour as well, so if you glug them, ideal for your toppers. So yeah, that'll just turn round. That's tied knotless knot onto a size 6 wide gape. That's a captor from Calder. Yeah, literally knotless knot, rig ring and a kicker, each shrunk. And that's on the dark matter braid. Love this stuff, it's really supple, easy to work with. And I've started to take a lot of fish on it, so most of my rigs nowadays will revolve around that. Moving up, got a nice little sinker and a dark matter kicker as well. Now these are different to the normal kickers. They're the dark matter tungsten range, so they're really heavy, really, really pingy. And as I say, you know that's going to be based down with the braid, the contours. If I'm over anything, that will sit nicely. So yeah, that's rig one. For rig two, we're having a little change. We're going on a multi-rig. So I've got a 15mm nutcracker pop-up. It's yellow, but I've actually glued it up, so it's gone to an orangey red colour. So yeah, as I say, multi-rig, you must be familiar with it. That's on a size 4 choddy. Little swivel, just tie the loop, tuck it through, back over it. And yeah, as I say, little blob of putty, sink up, kicker, trademark business for me. That's actually tied onto N-Trap Soft, 15lb. It's the old material that I always used to use. So as I say, yeah, we're going with that. That's going to go on the right hand rod, which is fishing this side of the bar. So basically the method in the madness is, if for any reason I do hit the clip and it does either ping back into the silt, or I go a little bit too far and I'm up against the bar, that bin of pop up will come down nice and slow and just settle wherever it lies. So as I say, that's the two rigs. So we're going to get them on the rods, get them out, and we're going to see Harry and see how he's going at it. Right, so the water's slack calm. We've seen a couple of fish up on the top taking the odd fly off the top. Doing this slack shallow bay to the right of Harry's swim. Started to feed the mixer. And as you can see, we're getting fish. Start to take and boil up. Harry's just nipped back to the van to grab a floater rod. We keep feeding them, build up their confidence, and hopefully we might be able to nick one off the top on the film for you. Well, we're giving up on the old mixers. As soon as we put the float in, they started to shy off, so we've left the bait out there. If we see the activity in the corner, then we can always pick the rod back up and get it back out, but they just weren't having it. To be honest, when the sun went in, I think that was pretty much it, to be honest. But yeah, we've had a few liners on the other two rods, so we'll just sit tight and hopefully the action picks up soon. Well, what a day we've had. In true Lee and Harry style, we never do anything easy. Tonight there's going to be a match on the lake. Only one side, which was the side we was fishing. So we've been told by the bailiff that we've had to move. And also there's a work party tomorrow, so we can't even go back to the original spots. I'm gutted because I'd have liked to keep working and we was getting liners, so there was definitely something in the area. But like I say, the rules are the rules. So we've jumped over to the other side into the dugouts. Harry's sitting up next door, so I'll let him crack on. The lake tends to come alive overnight when the sun goes down. When it cools right down, there was fish showing. I lost count how many last night. But today we've seen one or two, but mainly just cruising around under the surface film. So I've got a zig out at the minute. They was taking the mixer in the bay, but we couldn't catch one. So I've got on a brown zig, about 2 foot under the surface, just to see if I can wangle one. Like I say, I put bait out on them two spots that I was telling you about. I'm not going to fish them until the sun goes in and it cools down, because the fish are just not having it. But, like I say, in true Lee and Harry style, it's always, always against us. But it's the only way we keep the vlog going, so we'll muck on. Hopefully I might see you before later on, with a nice little silver end back pit chunk. But if I don't, then we'll catch up later on tonight when the rods go out. We'll review the day. But as I say, yes, it's not been the best. But we'll crack on, make the most of it, and I'll catch up with you later on.
On the zig, son.
21 pound of gold, mate, innit?
I was telling them why you was putting your brolly up. I'm gonna wang a zig out just under the surface. See if we can nick one.
And lo and behold.
And lo and behold, mate.
We've done it.
21 pound common on a bank. She's an angry old warrior, so I think we'll get the snaps done and get her back,
yeah,
son,
yeah? Definitely, mate, definitely get her done.
Happy days.
Good lad.
Get on the zigs.
On it.
Right, it's coming up 5 o'clock. It's match time. So we've had to reel in our rods. We can't put our rods back out until they finish their match at 8 o'clock. So we've got a 3 hour break. The bait's on the spots. Like I said, I haven't put any rods on the spots that I'm gonna be fishing tonight.
We managed to wangle one on a zig, which I was happy about. Like I said, I was cruising about, and as I say, if you couldn't get them off the top, sort of match the hatch, get on a bit of brown foam that sort of looked like a floater. And like I say, it was only in the water, 10 minutes, roared off, nice long half hour fight. Unfortunately, Harry was running back to the car at the time, so I didn't get none of the fight on film, but it was an epic battle, stunning fish. So as I say, we've got to wait 2.5 hours now for the old maggot bashers to do their thing. So I'm going to get my head down for a few hours, and then come 8 o'clock when they're off, we'll redo the rods, have a little chat with Harry, and we'll settle in for the night. So stay tuned, and I'll catch you in a bit. Right, coming up to the second night now then. Just get your rods out, son.
Yeah, mate, just about. It's a dark got settled in, but...
Yep.
Yeah.
So, we had to wait for the match to pass through, but... Like I say, 3 hours resting and swimming ain't a bad thing, mate, I suppose.
No. No, Geezer with the match had the 20 out, didn't he?
Yeah, right in front of him and all. Yeah. On maggots. On a 5 pound bottom and
mate,
all.
Mate, we spent all this money on bait and maggots.
Maggots
was the one.
Yeah, you know, didn't you? But, as I say, me and Harry got a rod each off the back of the bar. I've dropped a chod short just over the shelf, and you've pinged one to where they've been showing most of the evening, haven't you?
Yeah, we left them ones, just we see a few rings pop up, didn't we? So I pelted one over to there, and I said we both got one on the bar, but I think I've fell just short of it, and I didn't quite hit the clip. But.
Yeah. We'll see what happens, mate. Like I say, we've got all day tomorrow.
Yeah,
tomorrow night and Sunday morning.
We did get a bit of an head start with it, didn't we?
So yeah, mate. Yeah, well, like I say, two fish, mate.
Yeah, mate. You can't complain with it, can you?
No.
Like, we've done well. You've nicked the fish, I've nicked the fish. Mine was bigger.
But yeah, like I say, we'll see out tonight. If we have a fish, you know the deal. But as I say, if not, we'll catch up with you in the morning. We'll run through Harry's rig, what he had the fish on, and I'll take you through mine and all, even though it was pretty much standard zig. But we go through all that tomorrow. So until the morning, catch you in a bit.
Up last night about 6 o'clock, only a little one, but still nevertheless it's more than welcome. Seem to be doing pretty well here this weekend. Seems like a bit of a blessing in disguise, the fact that we didn't get to do the charity match. Seem to be hitting it off over here this weekend, but it's a small one, but like I said, nevertheless it's more than welcome.
Snap time, son?
Yeah, gotta do it, mate.
I think we've just equaled the most fish we've had on a V-log, and also,
we're
on a roll, son.
She's a proper pretty little one, this one, as well, mate.
Yeah, little starburst.
She's a little starburst looking thing, isn't she?
Right, son. Snap time, then.
Wicked.
Man.
Love it. Right, so the fishing's dried up, but I'll take this opportunity just to run you through my rig. It's pretty simple, pretty much the same thing that I showed you when we was down at base, just with a few minor adjustments. It's just 20 pound end-trap soft, tied on with a figure of 8 loop on the top there, just whizzed on to a size 11 swivel. Probably say it's about 8 inches long, with a bit of strip back section, probably about inch with a bit of putty just on the top there. As I don't like to use a putty, I just think it aids in the hooking. When the fish picks up your rig, you've got a little bit of weight there just to pull it down a bit. Got a kicker on there as always. This one from the Ace range, they don't do them anymore. But to be fair, I'd rather steam one to get a bit more of an aggressive hook, like a bit more of an aggressive turn when the fish picks up the hook. As always, trap the back of the air on the back of there. Got a size 6 wide gate from Calder. 20mm nutcracker. I've been doing a business. I've sunk 2 fish this weekend on this. So for me, it's just pretty much confidence in a ball. I'm not using a normal hybrid lead clip system. I'm using a helicopter system. The reason for that is there's quite a bit of silt out there. We're punching it quite a distance, and you don't really want that sitting, your rig sitting in the silt. So just to be sure of that, just fish it on helicopter rig, and you're winning.
She's beaten, mate.
Go on, get your fins up. Alright, well, there we go. Fish number 3 of the session so far. Beautiful little linear here. I'm well pleased with this one. You can tell I'm a bit out of breath. I don't think it's from the fight, I think it's from the adrenaline, although the fight was a little bit airy.
It's epic, mate, though, when it's going, mate. £19
on the button, mate.
Nutcracker strikes again.
Yeah, love it, mate, all day long. I've got to say a big thank you to Marcus Plum for the help, though. Appreciate that.
Let's have a get some snaps done, geese, and we'll might even get a nice little walk shot with this one, son, I mean.
Have it.
Have days.
Done it again.
Get it.
Thank you.
So Harry's nailing them. My spot slowed up, so what I've done, I've got the marker out. I found a little spot, it's not far, 10, 15 yards, past the shelf, 12 foot. It's the only place I can find with a bump until I come up against the shelf. So I've scattered probably 50, 60 nutcracker around it, just with a catapult, spreading them about, but there is a bit of bait there. I'm gonna stick a rod on that. Now the wind's dropping off, I'm gonna get the zig back out as well. And then while the zig's out, I'm gonna have a little lead about mid-water, probably halfway between the shelf and the bar for my left hand rod. But yeah, just working it really, just trying to nick another one before the night gets in. But like I say, Harry's doing well, he's nailing them. It is his stomping ground after all, and it is his turn as well, so I'll let him have his moment. And then the next time we go, it's my turn. Yeah, I wish that wind had dropped off a bit.
Right, so there we have it, third of the day, fourth of the session for me. Seems to be hitting it off. This one caught me a bit unaware. In true Harry Rees fashion, I was having a snooze, and this one belted off. Like I said, I'm well happy with it though. Proper nice old warrior again, isn't it?
Another stunner, mate, another stunner. Bang on a nutcracker yet again. Seem to be loving it in here, didn't they, today, mate?
They do, mate, definitely.
Was that £22 on a button?
£22, mate.
Happy days, guys.
You're well happy with it.
I'll get the camera out, snap time.
Snappy time, snappy snappy.
We'll get it back, son.
Yeah, look at
her. Great. Great. We'll be right back. Well, son, settling in for the last night.
Indeed, mate.
On the old Ender Silver back pit.
We had an eventful day today.
Yeah, mate. Yeah, three fish. Done well, didn't you?
Yeah, pretty good. You lost one.
Lost one as well, yeah. Did. Forgot to mention that. We Harry roamed off. His rod went, so I hit it. But little did he tell me, he was being a bit of a lazy angler, you see, because he'd caught all them fish on the same rig.
I couldn't help it.
So instead of tying a new one, like he should have done, he chucked it back out, I had the fish, and it rolled at the net, so we could have had another one.
And to make the best of it, it took me 2 minutes to tie up another one.
But yeah, like I say, it's just been a cracking V-log. We've done the record anyway, because we've never ever had more than three fish on a V-log, so for us to come here and have five, on the off chance of, on the back of, should I say, a failed trip, we've done well, because we weren't prepared.
And I did say to you though on the way over it, didn't I? So like, I had a bit of a feeling that this weekend we're sort of going to kick off. And we're saved by the snaps, weren't they? The fish that we caught are absolute minters. Like,
they're
mental,
mate.
You can't do better.
I wouldn't, to be honest with you, they're absolutely cracking, mate. You, all of them over 20 as well, so
yeah.
it's a winner, isn't it?
Absolutely.
But we might have a few more yet, anyway.
Yeah, you never know. The night's still young, mate. You know, we could tear off about 2 o'clock in the morning. Might drag you out of bed.
Drag me out of bed again.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't mind, mate. I've gone a bit unorthodox. I've stuck an adjustable zig out with a glow in a dark bug.
I don't actually think that's unorthodox though, guys. No. Do you know people fish just normal zigs
in
the dark?
Yeah, people do fish them, yeah. I mean, obviously, building up my old confidence on the zig, mate. You know what I mean?
You've done well past a couple of trips on them, haven't you?
Yeah, mate, yeah, so.
Picking up the bream and that, mate, you're a champion.
Oh, mate, I've cleaned up on bream this weekend, didn't I, mate?
I've cleaned up.
I tried not to mention that, you know what I mean?
I know.
Didn't even show them, you know what I mean?
Special, son.
I've had about 13 bream, but we won't tell anyone.
Well, beans, it was a special, we should have put them on camera, but we didn't.
Well, the dustbin isn't all, mate. It was about £16. Took a double 15 mil. But there you go. So yeah, like I say, settling in for the last night. It's been a good trip, as always. So we got till probably early, late morning, haven't we?
Yeah.
I want to be off by 12, so we'll probably wake up. If we have had a fish, we'll deal with that. If not, we'll wrap it up. But yeah, it's been a blinder. So we'll catch you in the morning. Right, well, there we go. This morning the rod roars off. Left-hand rod, double 15mm nutcracker. 18.5 pound mirror to end the session. We had a blinder, haven't we, H?
Mate, we had a really good session this session.
Six fish, lost one last night as well.
Yeah.
So, we're going to wrap it up there because we're losing battery on the camera. We've done 2 batteries, we've had so many fish. But, absolute blinder for the V-Log special, mate.
Yeah, mate, well chuffed.
Now watch out for episode 10, down in July. We're at Farlow's with Mr. Daniel Dineshi from UK Real Fishing. So yeah, on that note, we'll get the snaps done and I'll catch you in a bit.
It's goodbye from me.
It's goodbye from me.
And it's goodbye from me.